Hi guys, welcome back to our drone channel with the latest update of the DJI RC controller. The DJI Mini 3 series gained a new function which is called frame guide. How you activate it, what it is doing and how it helps you in your video production, I'm going to show you in this video, so stay tuned. If you like what you see, then help the channel to grow and subscribe. With the latest firmware update called 01030500, the DJI RC just gets some bugs fixed. That is what DJI has officially written. But there's one more thing DJI hasn't mentioned to you about the Mini 3 series. A kind of hidden feature has been implemented. This feature is called Frame Guide and was also enrolled for the Mavic 3 series within the current update. But what exactly is behind that designation? What I can tell you is that it is a really useful tool for your video post-production. Let me show you how you can activate it and which settings are available. First of all, click to the three dots in the upper right corner in order to open the settings menu of the DJI Fly app. Next, choose the camera tab in the upper navigation menu. Then scroll a bit down until you reach the menu item Frame Guide. As you can see, it is set off by default. Click the pull-down menu and you'll get a list of possibilities. While scrolling down, you see that there are many list items available. For the first test, we choose the one called 1:1 square. Tap the screen to close the settings menu. As we can see, a shade has appeared, forming a kind of frame and reducing the image size to a 1:1 square. Also, the screen grid is adjusted to the new image size. Let's imagine we are recording a reel for Instagram. With the help of this new function, we can have a much better idea of what the future video will look like. It is important to know that this is only a guide. The drone will still continue to record in the format you originally selected in the DJI Fly app. So there is no crop or something else of the final format. Okay, then let's test it for another frame. Click again the pull-down menu and scrolling down to the 9:16 vertical, creating, for instance, a TikTok reel. As you can see, the shade is much bigger and the new image size is the same as you would record in vertical mode. Nevertheless, the final footage taken by the drone is still kept in 16:9 horizontal. Alright, next we choose a format which has a smaller height than our recorded footage has. You can clearly see now a kind of cinema scope as the shades are drawn on the top and on the bottom of your screen. A lot of videographers working with this effect to create a typical cinematic feeling in the final production. Also here it's just a guide, but it helps the drone pilot to keep the object to be recorded in the correct frame. Switching to the final footage, you can see again that none of the footage is cropped and everything is completely available. And that's what it would look like if we put the cinema scope to the final recording. Well, is the frame guide also working in combination with other flight functions? Yes, it is. In this example, I have set the frame again to a 1:1 square and set up the spotlight function. The shades perfectly help the pilot to estimate whether the car is in the final and cropped recording area. In the post-production, it is easier as I am pretty aware of footage that will fit in my final format. Well, next we set the format again to widescreen in order to simulate a cinema scope. The drone itself is then set to active track in order to follow the car from behind. As you can see in the first perspective, the car is not in the later used visual area. By knowing this, I can scrap the footage during the shooting day and redo it instead of finding this out when working on the post-production. Even with the active track method parallel, where the drone sticks sideways to the car, the frame guide function works pretty fine. Basically, you can use it with each and every recording or shooting function of your DJI Mini 3 series drone, as it only affects the visual screen and not the drone itself. Believe me, it will make your drone life easier. So you should give it a try because it is a pretty welcome new feature. By the way, When restarting your drone, the last used frame guide is kept so that you do not need to set it again when changing the battery, for instance. Well, and that's it for today. What do you think? Will it help you within your video production? Drop me a comment below and let's discuss on it. By the way, if you are interested in further stuff regarding the Mini 3 and Mini 3 Pro, check out my other videos, like the one about the wide angle lens. If you like the video, smash the like button and don't forget to sub to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.